We are a legacy. We are the legacy.
Ocho.
Drip Bacardi.
Hello and welcome to the Bacardi Legacy Global Cocktail Competition Grand Finals. We'll be your hosts. I'm Dickie Cullimore.
And I'm Maitali Kong Sivalai, also known as May.
Together, we've been involved in this amazing event for, I don't know, how long now is it, May?
Oh my gosh. So many brilliant years, and we've traveled to some incredible cities around the world hosting these finals. I guess this year's a little bit different, but we are thrilled to be finally holding our global final with 39 bartenders who have worked so hard to get here.
Absolutely. What started out in 2008 as a pretty small event in London has grown to become one of the biggest cocktail competitions in the world and has provided a launchpad for countless bartender careers across the globe. In fewer than 2 hours, we'll be announcing who will be the next Bacardi Legacy Global Champion.
That's right. 2 days of semi-finals last week, we saw 39 of the world's most talented bartenders make their unique Bacardi Rum Legacy cocktail to be judged by a panel of experts. Only 8 have now made it through to the grand final tonight. Here in London, a new panel of judges will watch each presentation as a bar team recreates each of their drink to decide the winner. They will be looking for the next legendary classic Bacardi rum cocktail, a drink that can stand the test of time and establish itself as a worldwide modern classic. It's got to look and taste amazing will be something that bars around the world will want to recreate and celebrate. Now, a great Bacardi classic, or a great classic cocktail, also comes with a story, so we'll be hearing each bartender tell us their inspiration behind their cocktail creation.
All 39 of our competitors began their journey back in 2019, when they entered their local rounds of Legacy. The winners then spent months honing their drink and serving it to customers far and wide. So from over 10,000 bartenders in 112 different markets, 39 semi-finalists. Tonight we have our 8 grand finalists. Judging our grand finalists today, we have some of the most prestigious talent from the drinks industry.
Director of Mixology at London's award-winning Connaught Hotel, Agar Peroni, who won the first Bacardi Legacy cocktail competition back in 2008.
Monica Berg was placed number one on the 2020 Bar World 100 and co-owns Taya and Elementary, named Time Out's number one spot to drink in London in 2019.
Sandra Lawrence co-founded and runs The Cocktail Lovers, the award-winning magazine, website and now podcast. She has covered and judged Bacardi Legacy many times.
The global rum ambassador himself, Mr. Ian Burrell, founded UK Rum Fest and is currently the rum and cocktail specialist on TV's Sunday Brunch. The last Bacardi Legacy Global Finals took place in the beautiful city of Amsterdam in 2019. The title went to an accomplished and inspiring bartender from Bangkok, Ronapawn Kanavichapawn, whose self-assured on-stage delivery and delicious cocktail pick-me-up bowled the judges over. We caught up with Ronnie on the beautiful island of Puerto Rico early 2020, and we asked him to talk us through his experience of that week and how to come up with an award-winning cocktail.
Yeah, man. I'm gonna be honest, my goal to join this competition is I would like to get into top 8.
We are finally here
at the grand final of Bacardi.
After top 8, I feel like less pressure.
Where is the rum?
The winner of Bacardi Legacy is...
And when they announced, I didn't realize that's my name till Nikki is like shaking my arms. Me? I don't know how to say I'm gonna cry. I feel like I'm crying. Yeah, that's how I feel on that time. Pick Me Up, you can say it is in the category of Pick Me Up cocktail. When I created, I also told myself this is like taking risks. When people see tomatoes, see basil, they might like, maybe, but I think it's outstanding. When we talk about the savory cocktail, nowadays it's only Bloody Mary and their friends. But when we talk about rum pick-me-up cocktail, it still don't have in the market yet. They still have like the gap. And I just put my drink in that gap. So I think it's had a lot of potential.
Of course, when we spoke to Ronnie in that film, we had no idea what was about to hit the world. The pandemic has affected everyone, especially the hospitality industry, who have endured challenges none of us could have imagined. Now, this week's competition should have taken place last year in Miami, and all 39 of our competitors have come through an incredibly difficult year, and we felt we needed to do something extra to support them and the wider industry.
And who better to help the industry than the bartenders themselves? So a $5,000 grant has been made available for each of our competitors for them to invest in their bartender community. This El Coco grant is named after the iconic palm planted outside the first distillery in Cuba. That came to symbolise the strength and the resilience of a family and a company. Beyond our grand final, we'll be sharing with you the deeply inspiring stories arising from the enterprises our competitors have set up to change, improve, and support our bartending industry.
So, let's meet our 8 grand finalists.
Yeah, man.
Adam Dow, Australia. Prapakon Kongli, Thailand. Egvilija Bieloskaita, Lithuania. Alex Ariou, Cyprus. Konstantin Siglintov, Latvia. Vikingur Thorstensen, Iceland. Taylor Cloyes, USA West. Max Curzon Price, Canada.
Right, kicking off the final, let's meet Adam Dow from Dead Ringer Bar, Sydney, Australia. Adam, we'll be hearing about your amazing El Coco grant campaign to support women in the bar industry. I want to know, I'm sure we all want to know, what inspired you to decide to support this section of the community specifically?
Well, the industry's given me so much and I've had so many opportunities that others haven't had, so I felt an obligation to give back to the community in a really tangible way. gender inequality is an issue that's been plaguing our industry for hundreds of years, and anything I can do to bridge the gap is an important part of my legacy.
So Australia has had a fantastic relationship with Legacy. How does it feel to follow in the footsteps of so many great Aussie bartenders in a global final?
Yeah, Australia's always done really well at the global finals, and of course we hosted the global final here in 2015. I guess I've got equal parts support from the bartending community. I'm very excited, a lot of excitement around it, and a little bit of pressure to be the first Australian to win it. But I'm really just looking forward to showing a little bit of down under to the world.
Representing the great bartending country of Australia, Adam Dow with his legacy cocktail, the Golden Rule.
We drink Bacardi. G'day, my name is Adam Dow, your Australian representative for this year's Bacardi Legacy Global Final. I'm here today to present to you my Bacardi Legacy cocktail for 2020, The Golden Rule. It's inspired by Danny Meyer's book, Setting the Table. It's been a very exciting few weeks here for me. I'm now at my new home at Merivale as head of bars for Ivy in this great city of Sydney. And we're here today at Ivy's flagship, Pool Club. Now, during Prohibition, Bacardi had a saying that if they couldn't get their rum to America, they'd bring the Americans to Cuba. And so I'm very much bringing Miami to all of you. A pool and the sun out in front of me very much called for a party shirt, presenting to the coolest guy in the world, the rum ambassador, Ian Burrell. But this is the first time I've had the chance to present to Ago Peroni, and I wasn't gonna do that without a suit jacket on. But really, given the year or so the hospitality industry's had globally, I'm just really, really pleased to be able to present to you my Bacardi Legacy cocktail for 2020, The Golden Rule. In 2006, Danny Meyer wrote a book that would change the way hospitality professionals viewed customer service, and certainly the way I viewed being in service. That book is called Setting the Table, and it is my inspiration for my Bacardi Legacy cocktail for 2020, The Golden Rule. There's one simple rule to follow in hospitality, and that's the Golden Rule. Everybody knows the Golden Rule. Treat others as you'd like to be treated. But in Setting the Table, Danny Meyer wrote that the right way to approach this in hospitality and in life is to treat others how they wish to be treated. It's about being genuinely hospitable and giving serious thought to every facet of a guest's experience. It's service for one, not service for all. It's the same values instilled in the Bacardi company. I guess for Bacardi, it's always been about the golden rule of family. Monica, for you, maybe it's the special effort that staff at Elementary make to walk a guest through to Taya to continue a new experience. It's giving every competitor the chance to give back to the industry with the innovation of the El Coco Grant. And I'm very excited to be able to bring back the iconic Yuzu Breezer for this project and contribute an ongoing investment to the development of women in Australian hospitality. And Sandra, I know this is a topic very close to your heart. It's about creating the best experiences for guests in our bars and restaurants. It's approaching different guests differently every single time. It probably took me all of 10 years in hospitality to realize that most guests, even Australians, don't actually want to talk about cricket. And in my new role, overseeing a dozen venues and hundreds of bartenders, I have the platform to spread my legacy far and wide, not just in Sydney, but to hospitality professionals across the globe when it comes to service. And that is my legacy. And so the challenge for me was to create a cocktail that encapsulated Danny Meyer's message, that aligned with the Bacardi family legacy, and all while staying true to myself. And thus, the Golden Rule cocktail was born. The backbone of the drink is Bacardi Carta Blanca. Now, when I think of Bacardi, I think of this white, iconic rum, the old Bacardi Superior. It's gonna give the drink a lovely tropical base. So 50 mils per drink, delicious. Now, the most iconic Bacardi cocktails, like the Mojito and the Daiquiri, employ freshly squeezed lime juice. And the Golden Rule is no exception. 20 mils per drink. To balance the sour, the most golden liquid of all, honey. 15 mils of honey syrup per drink is gonna add a lovely texture and mouthfeel to the cocktail. I'm now gonna add 3 good dashes of Peychaud's bitters per drink. Our Payshords is almost never used in shaken drinks, but I think it's much more diverse than it gets credit for. It's going to speak volumes for the originality of the cocktail and give the drink a lovely rose gold hue. And now I'm going to shake this. Everyone! Hey! 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 Come on! Now, we're going to strain this cocktail back into the tin with a double strain. This is going to make sure that I get two very consistent drinks and two drinks with the same wash line as well. The drink's going to be served over a large block of clear ice, and that's going to help preserve dilution. I guess in an era where the climate is getting hotter and people are drinking less, I really wanted this to be a cocktail that people could savor over time. Now, the drink's going to be garnished with a spritz of rose water. This is going to add a final unique aroma to the cocktail. And the finishing move is a fresh red rose petal. Now, this is going to make the golden rule instantly recognizable. It's really replicable, super easy. You can even make it at home. And the rose is also a gesture to all of you, my guests for 6 minutes this evening, to be interpreted in any manner you wish. I love you, congratulations, sorry, well done, you choose. The cocktail presents a beautiful rose gold hue, the perfect colour for the golden rule cocktail in a golden era for cocktails, a golden era for Bacardi. The golden rule. I hope you enjoy it.
Amazing work, Adam, thank you. We now move to Southeast Asia to meet Prapakon Kongli, who works at Find the Locker Room Bangkok. It's been a challenging year this year with so many bars being closed. Tell us about how you've used your El Coco grant to bring more people to your legacy cocktail.
I hand the bar equipment to the new generation bartender. They can use it for practice, improve their working skill when the bar is closed. And I believe that when the bar can reopen, these people, they will find their own legacy.
It must be so inspiring to follow your countryman, our global champion Ronaporn, into the final. How has that motivated you on your legacy journey?
I met him 2 years ago after he won the Kobo Legacy competition. He's my inspiration. Now it is my chance to inspire the people, especially my daughters. And I would like to say thank you to all that support me. Without you, I won't be here.
So, with all of Southeast Asia hoping to keep the title in Thailand this year, we bring you Prapakon Kongli with his legacy cocktail, Out of Sight.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. My name is Prapakon Kongli, and I representing Thailand and Find the Locker Room. Before I begin, I have a question for you. Have you ever fell in love with someone that you have never even met? So let me take you back to the beginning. In Smui Island, 7 years ago, my life was a mess. I have no motivation, no passion, and no future. I started bartending because one of my friends got me a job. And at that time, I treat it as just a day-to-day job. And then one day, one sentence from my girlfriend rocks my world. Hey, Pok, I'm pregnant. Those forward from my girlfriend stir some negative emotion within me. Shock, fear, and confusion. How am I supposed to support another life when I myself is living a day-to-day? I live with that fear for weeks until the day of the first ultrasound. What a magical moment for me to seeing that first kidney silhouette of my baby on that screen made my heart beat fast with joy. From that point on, I gained the motivation to make something of myself and dedicating my life to someone that I have yet to meet. From that day on, I began taking my job more seriously, researching from books, YouTube, and other local talent around me. Even start taking language class. As I gain more knowledge, I start to love doing what I do and proud of being a bartender. So my cocktail is based from the flavor and ingredients that my girlfriend likes to have during a pregnancy. Starting from raw yogurt. It's creamy and tanginess flavor. And it's what all expected mother love. Fresh pineapple, a staple fruit in tropical island that is full of nutritional vitamin, adding juiciness to the cocktail. Agave syrup, a complex sugar, substitute for regular sugar that contains no nutritional value. Fresh lemon juice. Have you ever known any pregnant woman? They always craving something sour, right? Adding sourness to the cocktail. Fresh basil. Because my girlfriend loves stir-fried basil dish. And it also adds another spice dimension to the cocktail. Then finally, BACARDÍ Catarbanca. So BACARDÍ has always been a name that I'm familiar with, even before I knew exactly what it was. The name of BACARDÍ received its reputation as being a premium spirit that you can always call on. So you can't even say that BACARDÍ is what I strive to be. The classiness of BACARDÍ lifts up the flavor of fresh pineapple and basil. The nose of almond and vanilla helps round out the raw yogurt. And the subtle sweetness of BACARDÍ can be high in just a touch of agave syrup. Now, my inspiration, my determination combined to become the legacy out of sight. So if I were a musician, I would write the music for my daughter. But I am a bartender. Perhaps one day, when she was old enough, I, or any one of you, can serve this cocktail for her. And I hope that day, she will be proud of me, the legacy for her. A love for her that began when she was out of sight. Khob khun krab.
Khob khun maa ka, Prapakon. Right, we are delighted to introduce you now Akvile Bieloskaita, who works at the Alchemicus Cocktail Bar in Lithuania. Akvile, your drink and inspiration has a wonderful optimistic spirit to it. What has kept you positive during this last difficult year?
Everything happens for a reason. But I believe that sometimes positivity and optimism is something you have to learn. It can be, and it is difficult, but especially on times like we had for the past year, that is the most powerful strength you can have inside you. And that's why I never stopped doing that.
I feel like your drink is so delicious. I am curious to know how you discovered that the banana and dill, this really unusual pairing, works so successfully in the drink.
I'm a bartender. I believe we try different combinations all the time. So in this case, I had my now ex-coworker with me trying to finish this idea of lookup cocktail. And I knew that I want some sort of herb in it, but probably nothing that we already have in the bar. So I would call it a teamwork. That's why it is even more special to me. because it's not only about my thoughts, it's much more. And the fact that it worked is just a proof that good team can make miracles.
Well, the semi-final judges were certainly bowled over by the flavors of this drink, and I can see why. Let's see Akfile in action now as she brings us her legacy drink, Look Up.
We are the legacy.
Hello there, judges. Hello, everyone. I wish that I could be there with you, but for now, I will ask you to put your eyes up. Just look up for a second. Imagine your happy moment and just hold on to that feeling for a few more minutes. When I graduated high school, my grades were good. I was eager to learn. I scored high in my national exams. And then I went to university, right? Wrong. I ended up in the bar. Do you know how many people told me that I was wasting my time, my talent on a terrible career choice? And at that point, I wanted to never lose a reason why I started. So I started to look up. I looked up at my mentors. I looked up to my friends that I made. I looked up to opportunities that I never even knew existed. And I learned something. I learned something that I'm still figuring out because it's quite new for me. But I learned that if you take any job seriously, great opportunities can come to you. Taking that career path that almost everyone in my life neglected me for led me to this moment. And right now I'm making you my highball cocktail. In a world of Cuba Libres and mojitos, I decided to create a highball cocktail blooming with flavors that keeps you standing firm. I chose Bacardi Carta Blanca as my base for its purity and its crispness. And I decided to complement it with banana tasting notes, which is usually found in Bacardi Reserve and Premium ranges. Lime juice cordial, but to make a good and memorable cocktail, you have to find that catchy detail. I was lucky enough because I found that catchy detail in my local garden. And that was a dill. I said that I found it in my local garden, but actually I didn't. I got it at shop. You can get dill everywhere. It's absolutely available worldwide. But if we look at the definition of a highball is a cocktail consisting of a spirit and a mixer. My choice of a mixer is soda water. It's clear and allows all the flavors to shine through. Time for a shake. I wish I could be on stage right now because I'm not gonna lie, I quite like the applause. Aroma is good. A little bit of a taste test. Taste is great. I think clarity is a very important part of our lives. Clarity of our taste, because we are bartenders, right? Clarity of our heart, and most importantly, clarity of our mind. A few more drops. Yes, great. Look Up is a cocktail that is a reminder for everyone. And it is a reminder from myself as well, that when people look down upon you, you have to stand tall and you have to look up. Sometimes it's hard, I believe. But right now, I am standing here. I'm standing here tall. I am looking up, and this is my happy moment. So thank you, judges.
Thank you. Hello and welcome to the Bacardi Legacy Global Cocktail Competition Grand Finals. We'll be your hosts. I'm Dickie Cullimore.
And I'm Maitini Kong Sivalai, also known as May.
Together, we've been involved in this amazing event for, I don't know, how long now is it, May?
Oh my gosh. So many brilliant years, and we've traveled to some incredible cities around the world hosting these finals. I guess this year's a little bit different, but we are thrilled to be finally holding our global final with 39 bartenders who have worked so hard to get here.
Absolutely. What started out in 2008 as a pretty small event in London has grown to become one of the biggest cocktail competitions in the world, and has provided a launchpad for countless bartender careers across the globe. In fewer than 2 hours, we'll be announcing who will be the next Bacardi Legacy Global Champion.
That's right. 2 days of semi-finals last week, we saw 39 of the world's most talented bartenders make their unique Bacardi Rum Legacy cocktail to be judged by a panel of experts. Only 8 have now made it through to the grand final tonight. Here in London, a new panel of judges will watch each presentation as a bar team recreates each of their drink to decide the winner. They will be looking for the next legendary classic Bacardi rum cocktail, a drink that can stand the test of time and establish itself as a worldwide modern classic. It's got to look and taste amazing will be something that bars around the world will want to recreate and celebrate. Now, a great Bacardi classic or a great classic cocktail also comes with a story, so we'll be hearing each bartender tell us their inspiration behind their cocktail creation.
All 39 of our competitors began their journey back in 2019 when they entered their local rounds of Legacy. The winners then spent months honing their drink and serving it to customers far and wide. So from over 10,000 bartenders in 112 different markets, 39 semi-finalists, tonight we have our 8 grand finalists. Judging our grand finalists today, we have some of the most prestigious talent from the drinks industry.
Director of Mixology at London's award-winning Connaught Hotel, Agar Peroni, who won the first Bacardi Legacy cocktail competition back in 2008.
Monica Berg was placed number one on the 2020 Bar World 100 and co-owns Taya & Elementary, named Time Out's number one spot to drink in London in 2019.
Sandra Lawrence co-founded and runs The Cocktail Lovers, the award-winning magazine, website and now podcast. She has covered and judged Bacardi Legacy many times.
The global rum ambassador himself, Mr. Ian Burrell, founded UK Rum Fest and is currently the rum and cocktail specialist on TV's Sunday Brunch. The last Bacardi Legacy Global Finals took place in the beautiful city of Amsterdam in 2019. The title went to an accomplished and inspiring bartender from Bangkok, Ronapawn Kanavichapawn, whose self-assured on-stage delivery and delicious cocktail pick-me-up bowled the judges over. We caught up with Ronnie on the beautiful island of Puerto Rico early 2020, and we asked him to talk us through his experience of that week and how to come up with an award-winning cocktail.
Yeah, man. I'm gonna be honest, my goal to join this competition is I would like to get into top 8.
We are finally here at the
grand final of Bacardi.
After top 8, I feel like less pressure.
Where is the rum?
The winner of Bacardi Legacy is...
And when they announced, I didn't realize that's my name till Nikki is like shaking my arms. Me? I don't know how to say I'm gonna cry. I feel like I'm crying. Yeah, that's how I feel on that time. Pick Me Up, you can say it is in the category of Pick Me Up cocktail. When I created it, I also told myself this is like taking risks. When people see tomatoes, see basil, they might like, maybe, but I think it's outstanding. When we talk about the savory cocktail, nowadays it's only Bloody Mary and their friends. But when we talk about rum pick-me-up cocktail, it still don't have in the market yet. They still have like the gap. And I just put my drink in that gap. So I think it's had a lot of potential.
Of course, when we spoke to Ronnie in that film, we had no idea what was about to hit the world. The pandemic has affected everyone, especially the hospitality industry, who have endured challenges none of us could have imagined. Now, this week's competition should have taken place last year in Miami, and all 39 of our competitors have come through an incredibly difficult year, and we felt we needed to do something extra to support them and the wider industry.
And who better to help the industry than the bartenders themselves? So a $5,000 grant has been made available for each of our competitors for them to invest in their bartender community. This El Coco grant is named after the iconic palm planted outside the first distillery in Cuba. That came to symbolise the strength and the resilience of a family and a company. Beyond our grand final, we'll be sharing with you the deeply inspiring stories arising from the enterprises our competitors have set up to change, improve, and support our bartending industry.
So, let's meet our 8 grand finalists.
Yeah, man.
Adam Dow, Australia. Prapakon Kongli, Thailand. Ekvilija Bieloskaita, Lithuania. Alex Ariou, Cyprus. Konstantin Siglintov, Latvia. Vikingur Thorstensen, Iceland. Taylor Cloyes, USA West. Max Curzon Price, Canada.
Right, kicking off the final, let's meet Adam Dow from Dead Ringer Bar, Sydney, Australia. Adam, we'll be hearing about your amazing El Coco grant campaign to support women in the bar industry. I want to know, I'm sure we all want to know, what inspired you to decide to support this section of the community specifically?
Well, the industry's given me so much, and I've had so many opportunities that others haven't had, so I felt an obligation to give back to the community in a really tangible way. Gender inequality is an issue that's been plaguing our industry for hundreds of years, and anything I can do to bridge the gap is an important part of my legacy.
So, Australia has had a fantastic relationship with Legacy. How does it feel to follow in the footsteps of so many great Aussie bartenders in a global final?
Yeah, Australia's always done really well at the global finals, and of course we hosted the global final here in 2015. I guess I've got equal parts support from the bartending community. I'm very excited, a lot of excitement around it, and a little bit of pressure to be the first Australian to win it. But I'm really just looking forward to showing a little bit of down under to the world.
Representing the great bartending country of Australia, Adam Dow with his legacy cocktail, the Golden Rule.
We drink Bacardi. G'day, my name is Adam Dow, your Australian representative for this year's Bacardi Legacy Global Final. I'm here today to present to you my Bacardi Legacy cocktail for 2020, The Golden Rule. It's inspired by Danny Meyer's book, Setting the Table. It's been a very exciting few weeks here for me. I'm now at my new home at Merivale as head of bars for Ivy in this great city of Sydney. And we're here today at Ivy's flagship, Pool Club. Now, during Prohibition, Bacardi had a saying that if they couldn't get their rum to America, they'd bring the Americans to Cuba. And so I'm very much bringing Miami to all of you. A pool and the sun out in front of me very much called for a party shirt, presenting to the coolest guy in the world, the rum ambassador, Ian Burrell. But this is the first time I've had the chance to present to Ago Peroni, and I wasn't going to do that without a suit jacket on. But really, given the year or so the hospitality industry's had globally, I'm just really, really pleased to be able to present to you my Bacardi Legacy cocktail for 2020, The Golden Rule. In 2006, Danny Meyer wrote a book that would change the way hospitality professionals viewed customer service, and certainly the way I viewed being in service. That book is called Setting the Table, and it is my inspiration for my Bacardi Legacy cocktail for 2020, The Golden Rule. There's one simple rule to follow in hospitality, and that's the Golden Rule. Everybody knows the Golden Rule. Treat others as you'd like to be treated. But in Setting the Table, Danny Meyer wrote that the right way to approach this in hospitality and in life is to treat others how they wish to be treated. It's about being genuinely hospitable and giving serious thought to every facet of a guest's experience. It's service for one, not service for all. It's the same values instilled in the Bacardi company. I guess for Bacardi, it's always been about the golden rule of family. Monica, for you, maybe it's the special effort that staff at Elementary make to walk a guest through to Taya to continue a new experience. It's giving every competitor the chance to give back to the industry with the innovation of the El Coco Grant. And I'm very excited to be able to bring back the iconic Yuzu Breezer for this project and contribute an ongoing investment to the development of women in Australian hospitality. And Sandra, I know this is a topic very close to your heart. It's about creating the best experiences for guests in our bars and restaurants. It's approaching different guests differently every single time. It probably took me all of 10 years in hospitality to realize that most guests, even Australians, don't actually want to talk about cricket. And in my new role, overseeing a dozen venues and hundreds of bartenders, I have the platform to spread my legacy far and wide, not just in Sydney, but to hospitality professionals across the globe when it comes to service. And that is my legacy. And so the challenge for me was to create a cocktail that encapsulated Danny Meyer's message, that aligned with the Bacardi family legacy, and all while staying true to myself. And thus, the Golden Rule cocktail was born. The backbone of the drink is Bacardi Carta Blanca. Now, when I think of Bacardi, I think of this white, iconic rum, the old Bacardi Superior. It's gonna give the drink a lovely tropical base. So 50 mils per drink, delicious. Now, the most iconic Bacardi cocktails, like the Mojito and the Daiquiri, employ freshly squeezed lime juice. And the Golden Rule is no exception, 20 mils per drink. To balance the sour, the most golden liquid of all, honey. 15 mils of honey syrup per drink is gonna add a lovely texture and mouthfeel to the cocktail. I'm now gonna add 3 good dashes of Peychaud's bitters per drink. Now, Peychaud's is almost never used in shaken drinks, but I think it's much more diverse than it gets credit for. It's gonna speak volumes for the originality of the cocktail and give the drink a lovely rose gold hue. And now I'm gonna shake this. Everyone, hey, come on. Now, we're gonna strain this cocktail back into the tin with a double strain. This is gonna make sure that I get 2 very consistent drinks and 2 drinks with the same wash line as well. The drink's gonna be served over a large block of clear ice, and that's gonna help preserve dilution. I guess in an era where the climate is getting hotter and people are drinking less, I really wanted this to be a cocktail that people could savor over time. Now, the drink's gonna be garnished with a spritz of rose water. This is gonna add a final unique aroma to the cocktail. And the finishing move is a fresh red rose petal. Now, this is gonna make the Golden Rule instantly recognizable. It's really replicable, super easy. You can even make it at home. And the rose is also a gesture to all of you, my guests for 6 minutes this evening, to be interpreted in any manner you wish. I love you, congratulations, sorry, well done, you choose. The cocktail presents a beautiful rose gold hue, the perfect color for the Golden Rule cocktail in a golden era for cocktails, a golden era for Bacardi. The Golden Rule. I hope you enjoy it.
Amazing work, Adam, thank you. We now move to Southeast Asia to meet Prapakon Kongli, who works at Find the Locker Room Bangkok. It's been a challenging year this year with so many bars being closed. Tell us about how you've used your El Coco grant to bring more people to your legacy cocktail.
I hand the bar equipment to the new generation bartender. They can use it for practice, improve their working skill when the bar is closed. And I believe that when the bar can reopen, these people, they will find their own legacy.
It must be so inspiring to follow your countryman, our global champion Ronaporn, into the final. How has that motivated you on your legacy journey?
I met him 2 years ago after he won the Global Legacy Competition. He's my inspiration. Now it is my chance to inspire people, especially my daughters. And I would like to say thank you to all that support me. Without you, I won't be here.
So, with all of Southeast Asia hoping to keep the title in Thailand this year, we bring you Prapakorn Kongli with his legacy cocktail, Out of Sight. We are the legacy.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. My name is BACARDÍ Kongli, and I representing Thailand and Fight the Locker Room. Before I begin, I have a question for you. Have you ever fell in love with someone that you have never even met? So let me take you back to the beginning. In Smui Island, 7 years ago, my life was a mess. I have no motivation, no passion, and no future. I started bartending because one of my friends got me a job. And at that time, I treated it as just a day-to-day job. And then one day, one sentence from my girlfriend rocks my world. Hey, Pok, I'm pregnant. Those forward from my girlfriend stir some negative emotion within me. Shock, fear, and confusion. How am I supposed to support another life when I myself is living a day to day? I live with that fear for weeks until the day of the first ultrasound. What a magical moment for me to seeing that first skinny silhouette of my baby on that screen made my heart beat fast with joy. From that point on, I gained the motivation to make something of myself and dedicating my life to someone that I have yet to meet. From that day on, I began taking my job more seriously, researching from book, YouTube, and other local talent around me. Even start taking language class. As I gain more knowledge, I start to love doing what I do and proud of being a bartender. So my cocktail is based from the flavor and ingredients that my girlfriend likes to have during a pregnancy. Starting from raw yogurt, it's creamy and tanginess flavor. And it's what all expected mother love. Fresh pineapple, a staple fruit in tropical island that is full of nutritional vitamin, adding juiciness to the cocktail. Agave syrup, a complex sugar, substitute for regular sugar. That content is no nutritional value. Fresh lemon juice. Have you ever known any pregnant woman? They always craving something sour, right? Adding sourness to the cocktail. Fresh basil. Because my girlfriend loves stir-fried basil dish. And it also adds another spice dimension to the cocktails. Then finally, BACARDÍ Katrabangka. So BACARDÍ has always been a name that I'm familiar with, even before I knew exactly what it was. The name of BACARDÍ received its reputation as being a premium spirit that you can always call on. So you can't even say that BACARDÍ is what I strive to be. The classiness of BACARDÍ lift up the flavor of fresh pineapple and basil. The nose of almond and vanilla help round out the raw yogurt. And the subtle sweetness of BACARDÍ can be high in just a touch of agave syrup. Now, my inspiration, my determination combined to become the legacy out of sight. So if I were a musician, I would write the music for my daughter. But I am a bartender. Perhaps one day, when she was old enough, I, or any one of you, can serve this cocktail for her. And I hope that day she will be proud of me, the legacy for her. A love for her that began when she was out of sight. Khob khun krab.
Khob khun maa ka, prapakon. Right, we are delighted to introduce you now Akvile Bieloskaita, who works at the Alchemicus Cocktail Bar in Lithuania. Akvile, your drink and inspiration has a wonderful optimistic spirit to it. What has kept you positive during this last difficult year?
Everything happens for a reason, but I believe that sometimes positivity and optimism is something you have to learn. It can be, and it is difficult, but especially on times like we had for the past year, that is the most powerful strength you can have inside you. And that's why I never stopped doing that.
I feel like your drink is so delicious. I am curious to know how you discovered that the banana and dill, this really unusual pairing, works so successfully in the drink.
I am a bartender. I believe we try different combinations all the time. So in this case, I had my now ex-coworker with me trying to finish this idea of lookup cocktail. And I knew that I want some sort of herb in it, but probably nothing that we already have in the bar. So I would call it a teamwork. That's why it is even more special to me, because it's not only about my thoughts, it's much more. And the fact that it worked is just a proof that good team can make miracles.
Well, the semi-final judges were certainly bowled over by the flavors of this drink, and I can see why. Let's see Akvile in action now. She brings us her legacy drink, Look Up. We are the legacy.
Hello there, judges. Hello, everyone. I wish that I could be there with you, but for now, I will ask you to put your eyes up. Just look up for a second. Imagine your happy moment and just hold on to that feeling for a few more minutes. When I graduated high school, my grades were good. I was eager to learn. I scored high in my national exams. And then I went to university, right? Wrong. I ended up in the bar. Do you know how many people told me that I was wasting my time, my talent on a terrible career choice? And at that point, I wanted to never lose a reason why I started. So I started to look up. I looked up at my mentors. I looked up to my friends that I made. I looked up to opportunities that I never even knew existed. And I learned something. I learned something that I'm still figuring out because it's quite new for me. But I learned that if you take any job seriously, great opportunities can come to you. Taking that career path that almost everyone in my life neglected me for led me to this moment. And right now I'm making you my highball cocktail. In a world of Cuba Libres and mojitos, I decided to create a highball cocktail blooming with flavors that keeps you standing firm. I chose Bacardi Carta Blanca as my base for its purity and its crispness. And I decided to complement it with banana tasting notes, which is usually found in Bacardi Reserve and Premium ranges. Lime juice cordial, but to make a good and memorable cocktail, you have to find that catchy detail. I was lucky enough because I found that catchy detail in my local garden. And that was a dill. I said that I found it in my local garden, but actually I didn't. I got it at shop. You can get Dill everywhere. It's absolutely available worldwide. But if we look at the definition of a highball, highball is a cocktail consisting of a spirit and a mixer. My choice of a mixer is soda water. It's clear and allows all the flavors to shine through. Time for a shake. I wish I could be on stage right now because I'm not gonna lie, I quite like the applause. Aroma is good. A little bit of a taste test. Taste is great. I think clarity is a very important part of our lives. Clarity of our taste, because we are bartenders, right? Clarity of our heart, and most importantly, clarity of our mind. A few more drops. Yes, great. Look Up is a cocktail that is a reminder for everyone, and it is a reminder for myself as well, that when people look down upon you, you have to stand tall and you have to look up. Sometimes it's hard, I believe. But right now, I am standing here. I'm standing here tall. I am looking up, and this is my happy moment. So thank you, judges.
Thank you, Agvilia. Next up, we have Cyprus, a tiny island that consistently punches way above its weight in this competition. From Nicosia's world-famous bar, Lost and Found Drinkery, let's meet Alex Areiu. Alex, you're honoring freedom with your drink. What does freedom mean to you?
Freedom is everything. Being able to live under your own devices and have the ability to make choices that you want. That's freedom for me.
This is the fourth time a bartender from Lost and Found Drinkery has been in the global finals, making it the most represented bar in Bacardi Legacy history. What's the secret of your success?
two things. RTFM, read the rules, see what the competition asks for. And second one, fail to prepare and prepare to fail. Be ready for everything, and that's it.
Well, we're going to travel to Nicosia, Cyprus to see the spa now, as Alex makes his legacy cocktail, Lefteros.
Bacardi. Hello everyone, colleagues, friends, dear judges. I hope you're doing fine. My name is Alex, and I'd like to welcome you to my home, Lost and Found Drinkery in Nicosia, Cyprus. Δεν ελπίζω τίποτα, δεν φοβάμαι τίποτα, είμαι ελεύθερος. If you thought to yourselves that what you just heard is difficult to understand, it's because it literally was all Greek to you. This phrase is engraved on my favorite author's grave, and it roughly translates to, I fear nothing, I hope nothing, I am free. Lefteros then means to be free. Now there's a variety of ways to be inspired by freedom, either with words or acts for it. But I chose this one, because as it happened, I was named after one of his book's characters, Alexis Zorbas. You know, Zorba the Greek. Zorba's idea of liberty was a simple trifecta of having your glass full of wine, some food in your plate, and the person you love in your arms. Which sounds fine, but in my opinion is way more complex than that. Lefteros, to me, is the abstract idea of free will, my right to exist, and if circumstances are suited, to create. And what a better way to express this idea of Lefteros than this wonderful ceremony we call BACARDÍ Legacy. Because with BACARDÍ Legacy, you get to leave something behind for others to study, experiment on, and hopefully understand. If you want to build high, you have to have a strong foundation. So starting with the base of Lefteros, I chose a great Freedom Fighters masterpiece, the BACARDÍ Carta Blanca, a product that came to life after 10 years of almost obsessive experimentation. Besides rum, Don Facundo BACARDÍ Masso transformed the idea of freedom itself after being detained by his own people and being released later on. The following ingredients exist as elements of complement to Don Facundo's masterpiece. The same way their idea complement my idea of Lefteros. Lefteros should exist everywhere. It should be universal. It should be as easy to find as a lemon in a bar. And up to this point, Lefteros is universal. But I realize that it may not be for everyone. And this reminds me of the herb Thyme. Because Thyme, even though it's able to thrive in 6 out of 7 continents, because, you know, Antarctica is frozen, it is not a widely used herb like mint or basil, thanks to its bold flavors and aromas. Just like freedom, though, it's there for you to grasp if you're brave enough. My idea of Lefteros didn't always work. I sometimes found myself having those main elements of freedom, you know, my right to exist and the inspiration to create, yet something held me back. It was time. Timing is key. Waiting to see the right moment and strike. And this reminds me of the agave plant, in the sense that the agave plant takes 8 years to fully grow and mature to its full potential. Lefteros takes time then. Last ingredient. As it happened, I was raised in the only divided capital of Europe. And growing up on that dividing line, playing between barbed wire and armed soldiers, I know what restriction is. I even served in the army thanks to it. But on my country's flag, right under the unified island of Cyprus, stand 2 olive tree branches, a symbol globally recognized as the symbol of peace. If you want to be free then, no matter your ethnicity, no matter your gender or sexual preference, you have to be peaceful. Now please, excuse me for one moment. As you may have noticed, I only chilled the bottom half of my glass in order to keep the intensity of the aromas on the top. My name is Alex from Lost and Found in Nicosia, Cyprus. My legacy is the name I inherited. Freedom is my game. I know I am Lefteros. I know Don Facundo was. My question is, are you? Cheers.
Well, thank you so much to Alex and our other 3 grand finalists. We're going to take a few minutes here as our judges gather themselves ready for our next 4 competitors.
Whilst we do that, we are happy to bring you a short set by Dixon Brothers from London. One of many music artists BACARDÍ has collaborated with over the years in celebration of Sound of Rum. The Dixon Brothers also created the track Legacy, which you're hearing tonight, dedicated to our grand familiar and the spirit of BACARDÍ legacy for the past 12 years.
What's going on, BACARDÍ family? We are the Dixon Brothers and Kiss FM in the UK, and we are here to celebrate Legacy. Amazing cocktails, amazing entrance, and amazing finalists. This is a celebration of your hard work and craft. All right, Agent, shall we get into it? Shall we go? Shall we go? Shall we go? Let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get it. All right. Yes, BACARDÍ, come, let's get it in. Get your drinks up. Get your drinks up. We're going in. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Now we feeling wavy. Chilling somewhere in the tropics with my ladies. By the time my boy wanna. We gon' need some more.
Hey, to get my merengue on. Let's go. All right, we're going in, Let's go. BACARDÍ family, Dixon Brothers, Kiss FM, London, across the world, we're going in, let's go. Feel that heat, baby.
Sugar cane so sweet. So sweet. If you wanna do the conga, you got to listen to the beat.
I got shorty with me making plans on a jet.
Couple more sips on my lips and we set, baby.
Get what you want, pee what you want.
Say less, do more, get your body on the dance floor.
I got shorty with me making plans on a jet.
Couple more sips on my lips and we set, baby.
Get what you want, pee what you want.
Say
all right, we're going with them. Let's go, let's go.
Thank you so much to the awesome Dixon Brothers and welcome back. We have four more finalists to go, starting now with Konstantin Sigmundsev from Riga in Latvia. Konstantin, you're going to tell us a wonderful and less well-known story from the history of BACARDÍ in your presentation. I want to ask, what drew you to this as an inspiration for your drink?
It all starting with this poster. A long and interesting but little known case that the BACARDÍ company not only produced beer but also raised chicken to return to Rome production after devastating fire. This is a good story about non-standard solution and example of dedication.
So BACARDÍ legacy challenges us to better ourselves. How have you grown from this experience?
The story of my drink is about non-standard solution and faith in yourself. The history of the BACARDÍ family inspiring me during this challenge period for the bar industry. I really started think out of the bar and making unconventional business decision.
So with his delicious legacy cocktail, Wake Up Cool, representing Latvia, let's join Konstantin Sigmundsev.
Hello, my name is Konstantin. I am represent Latvia, and I'm very honored and happy to be in the BACARDÍ legacy final. Thank you, dear judges and all who supported me around the world. And now I prepare my cocktail for you. Let's start. How a BACARDÍ rum and chicken connected. It turned out for some time the company was involved in the breeding chicken. In fact, in 1808,
A fire destroyed the factory, and the company was on the edge of bankruptcy. The eventually some friend of the family, Enrique Sugar, offered BACARDÍ breed and sell chickens. This unexpected business solution helped the company not only get up on their feet, but also launched bravery and restart from the production. Okay, here we go. I have to try this. Excellent. Perfect. This little known case inspired me. It proved that even a disaster almost a no way out situation can be handled if you think out of the box and believe in your power. Anti-COVID restrictions have been on for over a year now. Bar industry is under a heavy crisis after the bartender and the bar owner. I have to try to survive on a daily basis. With my colleagues, just as BACARDÍ company early, try to take a look from different angle, look for new opportunity, and change the play on the go. We make pizza, dumpling, produce canned cocktail, and delivery food and drink to our guests ourselves. This is all to be back to our job to one day and stay true to the dream. I want to dedicate the wake up call to the cocktail to all my colleagues. It all for you. Doesn't matter who wins today. It is important that competition happened. It is another proof that of our straight proof that the bar industry it's alive and that it has a bright future. Thank you.
Thank you, Constantine, great job. We're headed now to Iceland to meet Víkingur Thorstensson from Jungle Cocktail Bar in Reykjavik. Víkingur, your cocktail is inspired by the seven continents, and we've seen a lot of change in the world in this last year. How has the bartending community of Iceland responded to the challenges it has encountered?
So, as you guys know, Iceland is such a small market. So, of course, it was hit very hard by the pandemic shutdowns, but it actually kind of became advantageous because it's such a tightly knit community of bartenders here that everybody's friends and family was willing to do basically everything and anything they could to help out and help businesses stay afloat. Also, there might have been a lot of time wasted playing video games, but you know.
So what does it mean to your local bartending community that you're the first ever competitor from Iceland in BACARDÍ Legacy, and now you're in the grand final?
So this being Iceland's first year participating in BACARDÍ Legacy, we were of course just incredibly happy to be participating in global finals. But now that we've made it to the top eight, it's really vindicated that Iceland belongs in BACARDÍ Legacy and that we're here to stay.
Well, it's nearly 24 hours daylight currently over in Iceland. Let's travel there as Vikingur presents his legacy cocktail, Pangaea.
Hi guys, my name is Víkingur Thorsteinsson, and I'm coming to you guys from the city of Reykjavík, proudly representing Iceland in Bacardi Legacy tonight. Welcome, and allow me to tell you guys a little bit about my legacy. So, today I'm going to be making you guys a cocktail inspired by the seven continents, using one ingredient to represent each of the seven. And yes, I'm aware I'm only allowed to use six ingredients in this cocktail, and while bartenders may not be known for their math skills, I promise you guys I'm not that bad at math. No. Indeed, today I intend to get away with making you guys my seven continents cocktail, Pangaea. Now, the continent that I'm going to begin with today is Africa. Why? Because today I've decided to muddle my basil instead of using a syrup in the spirit of keeping my cocktail as simple and easy to replicate as possible. Now, lots of basil is grown in Africa today, but thousands of years ago, basil was actually used by the ancient Egyptians. It was used as medicine, it was used as a symbol of mourning, but most interestingly, it was actually used as an important part of the process for embalming mummies and pharaohs, making the North African Egyptians the oldest civilization in recorded history to use basil. It's just a shame they didn't know how to make cocktails with it. Now, moving on to South America, the continent intended to represent the most important ingredient, the Bacardi. Now, why Bacardi? Well, quoting last year's winner, it's a Bacardi competition, duh. But my terrible jokes aside, I'm gonna be using Carta Blanca in my cocktail today. Now, my cocktail, it's very light and refreshing, making it not only very easy to make, but also very easy to enjoy and very approachable. And the Carta Blanca is so perfect for that because of its very light, citrusy, and of course, very, very approachable taste. Now, moving on to the vast continent of Asia. Now, the three largest producers of mango in the entire world actually hail from Southeast Asia. And in addition to that, mangoes are a huge part of the culture and the cuisine in that region. In fact, I actually grew up with a Chinese grandmother, and she used to say, a mango a day, make doctor no come. She was not good at English at all, guys, but she had the spirit, so, you know, gotta give her some credit. Now, moving on to North America, or as Americans like to call it, America. Now, way back when I was brainstorming ideas for Bacardi Legacy, I had a very heated debate with my colleagues about the geography of North America, and Mexico to be more specific. And well, since proving them wrong is pretty much my favorite pastime, I had to make it part of my legacy. Now, Mexico is the world's largest producer of limes, but is in fact located in North America, not South America, making a little bit of lime perfect to represent North America in my cocktail, and to prove them wrong. Now, moving on to the land down under, we have Australia, or as the world-renowned Dickie Cullimore calls it, Discount New Zealand. Now, since I can't put charming accents or deadly spiders in my cocktail, I had to do a little bit of research about Australia. And it turns out that Australia is actually the second largest producer of sugar in the entire world. And it's a huge part of Australian industry. In fact, it's actually their largest natural food export. And after all those North American limes, I need a good helping of sugar to help balance out my cocktail. Now, as you guys can see, I've got some delicious champagne here ready to top off my cocktail. But I'm ready to shake. Well, where is my seventh secret ingredient? I'll give you guys a hint. I haven't yet mentioned Antarctica. So today, I'm gonna be shaking with ice from Antarctica. All right. Awesome. Now, to answer your guys' questions, no. I did not actually get ice all the way from Antarctica. That sounds wildly expensive. Yes, I did base my entire legacy off of this one very, very lame joke. And lastly, no, I do not have any regrets about it. Alrighty, let's make sure these guys are nice and even. Ooh, perfect. Okay, now for the seventh and final continent, we have Europe. Now, champagne is so synonymous with Europe, and France to be more specific, that it can only be made within one very specific region in France, that of course being the Champagne region, making champagne just about one of the most European ingredients you can put in a cocktail, and making it perfect for my cocktail to help balance out some of that extra sweetness that comes from the Bacardi, as well as add some delicious texture. So now that I have made my cocktail for you guys, I would like to explain the name Pangaea. Now, about 175 million years ago, all the continents on planet Earth were not separated by mountains and oceans like they are today, but they were actually grouped together into one massive supercontinent known as Pangaea. Now, I just made you guys a cocktail with seven different ingredients from seven different continents spanning all corners of the world. But when I went to my local grocery store to buy these ingredients, I was able to find them all right there. Except for the champagne and Bacardi, that's because Iceland has some silly alcohol laws. Now, the reason for this is because of globalization. The reason for this is because of so many countries trading and sharing their cultures and cuisines with one another. The reason for this is because of all the countries on all the continents coming together into one Pangaea. And because of the beauty of this phenomenon, as part of our legacy, we originally decided to donate part of the proceeds from selling this cocktail to the largest charity on each of those seven continents. Yes, including Antarctica, the penguins need money too. Don't forget about those guys. But of course, unfortunately this year, our world was hit hard by a global pandemic. So instead, we've decided to go ahead and donate to the World Health Organization to help raise awareness and to help fight back against COVID. I hope everyone out there watching is safe and healthy. Thank you very much for your time. Please enjoy.
Right, we are heading west now to Los Angeles to meet Taylor Cloyes, who works at Here and Now Bar. Taylor, your drink is dedicated to women in the industry who've inspired you. I want to ask, now that you're in the grand final of Bacardi Legacy, what would you like to say to others who will be inspired by what you've achieved?
I was taught that talent is insatiable curiosity and ferocious courage. So I would say, allow yourself to be inspired. Jump. Jump before you're ready. Because you never know who's waiting to see your story.
And how did it feel when you found out you were in the final?
Like it's my birthday. It was amazing. I did start crying immediately. It's kind of par for the course for me. But it felt like all the work up to now had been leading to that moment. And then I was seen.
Let's join Taylor now as she makes a Bacardi Legacy cocktail maestra for us. We are the legacy. We are the legacy.
Ocho, ocho. We drip Bacardi. Maestra.
She's a master teacher. Now, to be a master teacher, you must be a master student. Hi, I'm Taylor Cloyes, and welcome to my home bar here in Los Angeles, California. I want to take a moment to thank the judges for the honor of their time, and to thank Bacardi and Lab 5 Agency for the opportunity to share this moment with so many people across the globe. I have been gifted in my life with many maestras, each one preparing me for the next until I found the one who would change my chemistry of thought. A true revolution of my mind, turning a girl who was kicking herself for not knowing everything into a woman who explodes with joy at every opportunity to learn something new, making me see my interest in everything, in anything, in a book, in a colleague, in a year of years. Cocktail. My maestra's name? Eden. La Gran Familia has also had many maestras in its time, both past and present, from Amalia to Maria to revolutionary Elvira, to the women who were my spectacular competitors all along this journey, to the women who sat across judging tables from me and took my measure. I don't stand here alone. None of us do. We women, we blend and shape the legacy of the party the same way that the maestros de ron, they blend and shape the rum itself. This is time and story in a bottle. I'm like a person full of hope and resilience. When we reach for Bacardi, we reach into the past and we invoke the power of those maestros who have come before to remind us that it's our turn now. not to blend and shape the world as it was, but as it could be. And so, these maestras, they can only begin with Bacardi Gran Reserva Ocho, a barrel-aged blend. Don Facundo's original recipe from over a century ago. A protected legacy. A spirit of resilience shared with us by La Gran Familia. Next up, straight out of brandy. Marrying the age in one spirit to another. Spirit of its own revolution. Lemon, brightness. Egg white for texture and character. A little bit of effervescence at the base to give her the lift she needs at the finish. To control and shape that dilution with intention. And lastly, an expression all my own, a cordial made from crisp green apples, because the women I speak of, they are not the red apple women some might think of. Neither are we in this industry. We reach for the life with a little more bite. Let's shake it up. Who's the maestra in your head? What is she trying to tell you? Are you listening? A little bit of ice. A chill. The maestras of my life and the maestras of Bacardi, they are now powerful threads in a legacy that is all my own. But to every woman who lifts up those around her by virtue of her character and the sharing of her masterful knowledge and skill, I see you. Thank you. And to those still waiting to be seen, I tell you now, wait for nothing. Shine now. Because this is the power of woman. This is a Bacardi legacy, living and breathing. This is maestra.
Thank you so much, Taylor. And now we find ourselves meeting the final of our eight competitors tonight. Max Curzon Price works at the Botanist Bar at the Fairmont Pacific Rim Hotel, Vancouver. Max, we're going to be hearing about your campaign you've been running to sustain the honeybee population. What sort of feedback are you getting from the bartenders who have taken part in this so far?
Some of the bartenders have been reporting back that throughout this challenging year that we've had, having this hive and a colony to nourish and to nurture has given a real sense of responsibility and accountability, something to really grow with.
What does Bacardi Legacy mean to you?
Well, included within Bacardi Legacy, but also beyond it, I don't think legacy can exist as an individual. It's about building an opportunity for community, opening doors for others, and providing a space for us to all grow. Whether that exists within our lifetimes or long, long beyond them.
It's inspiring stuff. We will now take our final trip to Vancouver as Max introduces us to his legacy cocktail. We are the legacy. We are the legacy.
Ocho, ocho. We drink a Bacardi.
Good afternoon. My name is Max Curzon-Price, and I'm your Canadian Bacardi Legacy Top 8 finalist. And that is a pretty cool sentence to say. Today, I'm making you my cocktail, Plight of the Bumblebee. I'm joining you from the heart of downtown Vancouver here, where I work, a botanist. Now, a botanist, our approach to writing a cocktail menu is when we try to study and analyze the flora and the fauna of our neighborhoods. In doing so, we're able to create a high-impact guest experience with a low impact on our environment when we go to pull the ingredients, the resources that we need. It's through some of these studies that I came across an article in 2019 stating that the honeybee is the number one most important living organism on our planet. Honeybees contribute 75% to wild pollination of food sources. So forget humans for a second. Let's think about all life, all creatures, and their needs for wild food sources, nuts, seeds, and berries. That all comes down to the humble honeybee. Yet year on year, we're continuing to see honeybee populations diminishing. So I wanted to combat this, and I centered local honey at the heart of my Bacardi Legacy campaign. The passion, the energy, the fire, however, I took that from Don Facundo. See, when Facundo founded Bacardi Rums in 1862, he did so with the knowledge, the understanding, the competitive market, the rums they were producing were kind of crude, unpolished. He introduced simple but revolutionary techniques, aging in American oak and then filtering through charcoal. And he changed the rum industry forever. For 159 years now, bartenders like myself and my fellow legacy competitors reach for Carta Blanca as a benchmark of quality. Now that's the energy that we need to catalyze in changing the way our industry thinks about honey. We should be turning away from synthesized manufactured bee products and investing in the flavors of our own community. When we do so, we see pollinator populations bounce back fourfold in our own cities. And what we're rewarded with is an ingredient that evolves and adapts depending on its location. And that's what makes Plight of the Bumblebee so special. It's always familiar, but endlessly unique to the location, the season, the people that you enjoy it. Wherever you are in the world, it adapts. Well, the best way for me to demonstrate this is to make you Plight of the Bumblebee. I always start my legacy cocktail with my own local honey. And when I say my own, this honey comes from a hive that I tend to myself in the heart of downtown Vancouver. This honey is the same honey that's being poured for the judges in London today. Friends, please enjoy a taste of my drink. Next up, we want to find a little tropical rhythm for that honey to dance with. Fresh grapefruit juice. Now, I love the florality that grapefruit brings to the mix, but let's be honest. It lacks a little bit of acidity. So we'll borrow an old tiki trick, blend in our citrus, and bump up that acidity with a whisper of lemon juice. Now from here, we want to do the exact same thing, but pull up some of the bitterness. Martini bitter, perfect tool for the trick. But now this is when we come to the rum. I remember so distinctively the first time that I ever tasted Bacardi Ocho. Nose in the glass. Baking spice, orange peel, toasted coconut. Whoa, like beeswax. That beeswax note was so unique. It was the first time that I tasted it in a rum, and it's my constant grounding anchor. The Bacardi Ocho is the only rum for Plight of the Bumblebee. So throughout my legacy campaign, I managed to establish this drink in 34 different cocktail bars, in 14 different countries, all 7 continents of our planet, and together, we sold almost 9,000 Plight of the Bumblebees. But I didn't want to just stop there. I asked those supporting bars if they'd be willing to donate $1 from every one of my cocktails sold. And with those funds, we could provide international qualifying bartenders to take an advanced beekeeping certification to receive their first hive, starter colony, and queen bee. A program, bartender to beekeeper. Now, much like some of my climate goals, let's say we shake this up. Thank you. that program, bartender to beekeeper, it's now self-motivating, self-sustaining. It's one that's going to continue to exist long after Bacardi Legacy 2021 wraps. You could say it's a legacy. Apply to the bumblebee, this cocktail. This might be my legacy. But it's not a legacy that I built for myself. Apply to the bumblebee is a cocktail that allows us to break down the four walls of our bars and gives us an opportunity and a space to think about the species who cannot protect themselves. Cheers to that.
Thank you to our final four competitors. Our judges are taking some time now to decide who will be the top three and who will be our overall champion. But before we break with some sounds from the Dixon brothers, I'll explain for you a little bit about what the judges are looking for. We're looking for a cocktail with a great name and strong inspiration. A drink that's original, but at the same time replicable. Something that can be made in great bars across the world. They have to deliver an engaging performance with perfect technique that really shows off the craft of bartending. And of course, my favorite part, the cocktail itself. It must look beautiful. It has to have real visual appeal. An aroma that's enticing, and then taste, mouthfeel, texture, and finish. These are the elements that come together to create a great Bacardi Legacy cocktail.
Yes, yes, microphone check, 1, 2, 1, 2. What's going on, Bacardi family? We are the Dixon brothers from Kiss FM in the UK, and we are here to celebrate legacy. Massive congratulations to all the entrants, all the finalists. You guys have been amazing, and we are here to celebrate with you. Now, this track is our own track, produced with super producer Dukas, and it's fire. So let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
We are the leaders, I'm a believer, we can be champions. They're gonna feel this, they're gonna see us up on the podium. We can run the world, cause we're never backing down. And we can run the world, cause we're never backing down. And we can be stars.
Alright, Bacardi family, Dixon Brothers Legacy. Let's get it, let's get it, let's get it.
This is the party. When you see us there, we drink Bacardi. We are the legacy. Like that familia. When I say uno, dos, tres. This is the party. When you see us there, we drink Bacardi. We are the legacy. Like that familia. When I say uno, dos, tres.
Yeah, we are the legacy.
All right. Pull it up, pull it up, pull it up. All right, back in again, Bacardi family. We are going in twice. Get your glasses up. Get your glasses up. Put them up, put them up. Let's go.
We are the leaders. I'm a believer. We can be champions. They're going to feel this. They're going to see us up on the podium. We can run the world because we're never backing down. And we can run the world because we're never backing down.
We're going in, let's go!
This is the party. When you see us there, we drink Bacardi. We are the legacy. Like that familia. When I say uno, dos, tres. This is the party. When you see us there, we drink Bacardi. We are the legacy. Like that familia. When I say uno, dos, tres.
Yeah, we are the legacy. No nos afecta, no. Vamos a conquistar el mundo, no vamos a fallar.
allá. Vamos a conquistar el mundo, no vamos a fallar. And we can be stars, be stars, be stars. And we can go far, go far. We are the legacy. And we can be stars, be stars, be stars.
Legacy, Dixon Brothers, Dukas, BACARDÍ family. We're going in, we're going in, we're going in, we're going in, let's go. Looking forward to some amazing cocktails from you guys. Congratulations to all the entrants, all the winners. It's the one big familia. That's how we get down, Dixon Brothers, let's go. Is my trick. All right. Let's go, let's go. Peace.
Yeah, man.
Welcome back, everyone. We hope you are as excited as we are. We are only moments away from finding out who is our 2021 BACARDÍ Legacy Global Champion. Now, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank Aga Peroni, Sandra Lawrence, Monica Berg, and Ian Burrell, our amazing judges, for the care and attention judging today's prestigious event.
Thank you again to our 8 competitors tonight. We'd also like to give a huge thanks to everyone out there watching now, and indeed everyone who has given these incredible bartenders their love and support throughout their legacy journey. So, the time has come for us to reveal to you who the top 3 finalists are in this year's BACARDÍ Legacy. Well, we are here. We made it. We are back live. I am super excited to announce our top three finalists are Peppercorn Kongli, Thailand. Adam Dow, Australia. And Max Curzon Price, Canada.
And the winner of Bacardi Legacy 2021 Congratulations, is...
and thank you to our top three. What's it like to be champion? We live?
Yes.
Congratulations and thank you to our top three. What's it like to be the Bacardi Legacy Global Champion? Look, there's really no better person to tell us who it is. Over to Ronaporn.
Sawadee krab.
Hello everyone, this is Ronaporn, the Global Champion of Bacardi Legacy 2019. I'm so impressed with our Osho Grand Finalists and would like to congratulate with your incredible journey to get to today. Also, I would like to pass my best wishes to the new champion. Trust me, your life wouldn't be the same. If you wanna know how it's different, just like text me in personal, okay? And once this pandemic is over, I wish I can meet you guys in person and celebrate together. Welcome to La Grand Familia.
Congratulations to our top three. Thank you for the incredible effort and we are so grateful for everything that you've done since the end of 2019 to bring us here today. And I'd like to hand it back to Ronaporn to announce our next Bacardi Legacy Global Champion.
And the winner of Bacardi Legacy 2021 is Prapakon from Thailand!
Congratulations to Peppercorn. What an amazing performance. What a fantastic and delicious drink. We are so grateful for everything that you've done. It's been an incredible year. It's been a crazy year, but we made it. I'd like to thank everyone who's watched along, who's supported our bartenders in this incredible journey that they've had. I'd like to thank the people who have made Legacy possible year on year. The Bacardi team that I work with, Lab 5, our key partner agency, thank you very, very much. And to Peppercorn, congratulations. Your year is going to be like nothing you could ever imagine. I look forward to sharing that with you. So to all of you, thank you very much and good night. We are the legacy. We are the legacy. We drink Bacardi. We'll be right back.